Welcome to the Anime and Gamer's Guide to Japan, where we talk about everything we've ever seen or done in Japan. We're your hosts, Kris
and Judy.
And on this episode, we're going to be talking about something that's been making a lot of news in Japan, believe it or not.
Yeah, something kind of surprising. I never would have expected this.
Mm-hmm. And believe it or not, it has to do with McDonald's.
Yeah.
Something you also don't associate with Japan, really.
Yeah.
It has to do with the Mega Mac that they've brought out over there.
Yeah, it's basically, like, think of two big Macs stacked on top of each other. It's mm-hmm. four patties, like three buns.
It's huge. I don't know how you can fit it in your mouth.
It's enormous. It's like the size of my head. And it's really popular over there. It's completely selling out. They've had to, like, it was supposed to be just a limited time thing. They're extending the time period.
They keep running out of them at every single restaurant that they have. That's so bad that they've been giving out coupons so that they can come back and get them at a discounted price later.
Yeah, we're like, we're sorry we don't have the Mega Mac for you, so come back later, you know, when we have one and you can get like a buck off or something like that. Mm-hmm. And it's just, it's been so popular, which is really strange.
Like, because when you think of it, I mean, there's hamburger joints that are over there and that you see, but I mean, I always think of the Japanese with presentation and everything else, and you go over there and there's this huge thing, and I remember, I think it was one of the commercials that they were showing off, all these people eating it, and it was like gushing out the sides, yeah. And you know, they pushed it as like being the meal.
Yeah, well, and another thing is that usually, like, even at McDonald's in Japan, portions are very small, which mm-hmm. is, you know, well, probably more normal than they are in America. They're very large in America. But yeah, portions are a lot smaller. You know, you get a normal, like a regular size drink, and it's really tiny, you know, and like,
and it's,
yeah. And like, but all of a sudden, here's this ginormous hamburger that's like 50 times bigger than anything else on the menu, and people love it.
It's just selling out like crazy.
Because like, what's the nutritional stuff on it? It's like,
I think it's like 750 some calories.
Yeah,
just for the sandwich.
Yeah. Yeah, and they're calling it like 750 calories of nutritional energy. And it's like, wow. What a way to push it.
And it's worked, though.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Of course, if you're going to Japan, you may be able to find this. You probably won't be able to find it when you actually go into McDonald's.
Yeah,
we kind of avoided McDonald's, so we didn't really see too much of that when we were there.
Yeah, at least not when we went on our trip. Although, I used to stop there. Maybe like once a week, maybe.
Crave home, huh?
Well, not exactly. They actually had, what I usually got was the teriyaki burger, which is, it was really good.
Teriyaki burger, huh? I love the regional differences you find with restaurants.
Because
everything you think you're going to find, when you go to some other country, doesn't matter where it is, it's not going to be the same as what you remember from back home.
Yeah, yeah. There's teriyaki burgers. There's a chicken sandwich that they have that has ginger on it. I didn't get a chance to try that, but that sounds kind of interesting.
Yeah.
And they've got like melon shakes, and there's a shrimp burger that's
ooh,
like,
yeah, shrimp burgers.
Yeah, all sorts of interesting stuff. Of course, they also, you know, if you're panicking like, oh, I'm going to Japan and I can't eat shrimp, you know, well, I feel sorry for you, but there's also the normal stuff. There's like double cheeseburgers and all the traditional McDonald's trappings are all there.
So. Yes, so you can still find the regular stuff, you know, apple pies or whatever.
Yeah.
But you got to try some of the more exotic things. Do they have the green tea ice cream?
I don't believe so. Not at least at the ones that I went to.
Yeah, because if you're walking around, I remember when we were out, this kind of getting off the McDonald's topic, but I remember we were out, we'd go around and you'd see these great big ice cream cones, and they'd be, instead of like in America, where you find them where they're like white, they're green.
Mm-hmm.
And you could see them from really far away because they were much easier
like
to spot.
The big plastic display ice creams are green.
It was, yes, oh, that was really good.
Awesome.
But you got to try the ice cream if you go over there too. It's really good. So,
and
can't find it at McDonald's. I'm sorry.
And, another cute difference that might be interesting to note is that here we have like a Happy Meal. In Japan, it's called a Happy Set, and just because it's probably easier to pronounce. And I think right now the toy that they have running is Dragon Ball Z of all things in the world. Oh yeah. Oh, it's still so popular. Like there's, if you go to the Japanese McDonald's website, they have like a little commercial library,
mm-hmm.
and they have the funkiest commercials. Like there was one like kids meal commercial I saw where it was all these kids come out of McDonald's, and they still they have a Japanese Ronald McDonald.
Yes,
he's there
do.
Too.
Yes.
And so all the kids come running out, and this one girl, she's got a balloon, but oh no, she lets her balloon go and it starts flying away, and she's like, oh. But so then the McDonald's restaurant, or how did it go? I think it was the McDonald's restaurant transformed into a robot and grabbed her balloon. I just remember that that McDonald's transformed into a robot, as was the highlight
only
of the girls.
In Japan. You, next thing you're going to see is Godzilla bashing through the side, you know, and helping you out. The drive-thru that goes through and everything. Yeah. Good Lord.
So, yeah, so it's McDonald's. It's just got a Japanese twist on it, of course.
So if you're over there and you're with friends who want to have, taste of home, or you've been over there for a really long time, you can go get your McDonald's fixation at the local McDonald's that's over there.
Mm-hmm. And they are everywhere, so you'll be able to find them pretty easy.
Mm-hmm. So if you're hungering, go visit McDonald's.
Yep, and try out the Mega Mac if you can.
Yes, if you can find it.
And if you can eat it.
And until next time, this is your host, Kris.
And Judy.
Signing off.